This is a very exciting moment for us. One which we've been waiting for the past 2 years. And I've been given the honor and opportunity to present about our project on behalf of hundreds of Martians. And I don't want to bore you with numbers and statistics, but I want to give you reasonings. Today, we're living in a generation of science, innovation, technology that not only transform the way we live, but to transform where we live. We're living at the beginning of history, at a unique location that has the richest history and uniqueness that has to offer for the Mars vision. Many of us sitting in this room today has, to some extent, found their answers to why Mars. As Dr. Zubrin defined, this is where the science is. This is where the future is. And this is where the challenge is. But then you might be thinking, why Mongolia? Because this is where the environment is, the history is, and the adaptive survival lifestyle is. Here's how. To the eyes of a globalized metropolitan world, Mongolia is a developing nation struggling with resource curse, or even, let's say, a herder nation trapped between the world's greatest economies. But beneath the surface, we have rich history and extreme climate conditions that has transformed our way of living. This hundreds of years of living in Mongolia has transformed its people with adaptive and survival lifestyle skills. Always ready for a challenge. Nomadic Mongolians possess the best knowledge of how to recognize and use resources to its maximum capacity with zero waste in the wilderness environment. A truly compelling lifestyle. And our history proves that. So three things: the environment, the history, and the adaptive survival lifestyle. These three things together define Mongolia's competitive advantage as a nation for this mission. So now, I want to walk you through where we contribute and how we contribute for this mission. Every once in a while, technological advancements are introduced by the governments, but maybe more so now by the space entrepreneurs, making space travel much easier, cheaper, and accessible. So now, let's imagine that the transportation system has been created. What's next? Next is the Mars settlement. So to establish the Mars settlement, there are numerous technologies that need to be developed, tested, and evaluated, such as Martian spacesuits, surface vehicles, robots, or even planting greenhouse agriculture in the environment, in the exact extreme environment. And this is what Mongolia has to offer. And this is where we contribute. Just to share some of our developments, we have designed the beta version of Martian spacesuit, rover, and dome, which is inspired from the traditional Mongolian gur. If you want to understand how a traditional Mongolian gur can be the most resourceful and utilized area to inspire for the development of a dome, then I invite you here. And I leave the philosophy to you. Moving on, many developing nations have set their, or let's say developed nations, have set their Mars ambitions. Whether it's public, private, they're somewhat linked with geopolitical agendas. whereas our contribution is towards creating the Mars-like environment in Mongolia and also preparing the people with adaptive survival skills. And this will be achieved through developing training base, an R&D free zone, and a satellite city. In other words, this will be a truly borderless co-working space. And by that, I mean people from all over the world can come and join forces to collectively contribute for this mission, mankind's mission for Mars. So to reach this goal, we have passed the test of rationality in the past 3 years. On an institutional level, we're members of International Mars Exploration Working Group. We're members of Mars Exploration Program Analysis Group. We have presented to NASA, Indian Space Research Organization, and even to President Putin. But I want to highlight over here, we have onboarded many science and thought leaders led by Dr. Zubrin and Dr. Akiyama as our honorary advisors. Your contributions are greatly valued. On the internal side, for the past 3 years, we have the feasibility study approved by the Ministry of Environment and Tourism. We have established the government working group, which is aimed towards creating a fostering, nurturing environment for investment and public-private partnership in developing Mars V project. And very excitingly, very recently, we have obtained the rights to use land in the Gobi for this exact mission. So, our message is that Mongolia has a space mission, Mongolia has a Mars vision mission backed by reasons. We have government support, we have legislative support, we have scientific support, and most importantly, we have our people's support. Mongolia is ready to enter the global vision for Mars, and our commitment to it is absolute. We need supporters, we need investors, and we need you. And I invite you to join us. Thank you.